Good morning, Mr. Tan. We are from Group 2. So before we start our presentation, please allow me to introduce my team members. She's Sunny, Amy, and Rachel. And me is Angie. So for the introduction, in future, there are three of the most educated generation that will take the lead and converge in the workplace. The three generations are Generation X, Generation Y, and Generation Z. The so-called most educated generation is because these three generations were accepted the formal education since in the US. They are having a well, proper, and a series of complete educational systems since they are young. And for the Generation X, they are also the middle child in generation. They were born between 1965 to 1980. This is the generation that to be emphasized to earn less than their previous generation, which is their parents. And in workplace, Generation X is ambitious and eager to learn new skills, but they like to accomplish things on their own terms. Besides that, Generation X works to live rather than live to work. As of 2010, their asset will statically double their debts. And from World Cup 2014, a good way to motivate a Generation X employee would be explain the details and expectation of a job and then leave them alone to accomplish it. So the next one is Generation Y. The other name of Generation Y is Millennials. They were born between 1988 to 1990. Technology is a part of their daily life, and they also consider workplace is a place for them to learn and grow. So they prefer to work wisely and save time for themselves, and a good working environment to achieve their personal goal. They will also see the balance of work and family as important. So the next one is Generation Z. So they were born between 1995 to 2015. They are living in an era of science and technology. Technology grows faster in this generation. For example, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and Snapchat. So in this generation, social media plays an important role. And Apple product is getting important among the young people. Although those products are expensive, but with its unique feature, many youngsters are craving for it. And they will explore themselves in the workplace. They also need a platform to let them show their talent with their creative and their inherent skills. So this is the characteristic of Generation X, Y, and Z. The table shows the work style, career goals, and the value of Generation X, Y, and Z. For the work style for the Generation X, they are independent, critical thinking, spirit of sacrifice, and faithful. For the career goals, they are for money, for the better life, and make some changes. For the value, they are people with freedom, independence, insightful, and dedication, religious. For the Generation Y, the work style is think big, enthusiasm, ambitious, ready to face challenges, confident. And for their career goal is money and better life. Their value is productivity, innovative, create a good living environment. For the Generation Y, their work style is willing to try something new, strong desire, teamwork, energetic, socialism, technological. And for their career goals, they are for money, high quality lifestyle, and to achieve their personal goals. Their value is young, patient, time, and globalization. So pass it to Rachel for the next slide.
Thank you, Angie. So I'll be continuing the presentation by explaining the expectation of Generation X, Y, and Z. So first, we'll look into the expectation of Generation X. According to Murphy 2010 and Haynes 2011, Generation X relies on their own judgment, which means that they don't rely on the authorities, which makes them an independent problem solvers. According to Hamia 2005, He did mention that Generation X are less likely to obey the rules in organizations because they think that the hierarchy of authorities is less important than any other generation rules. This means that the autocratic leadership might not work on the Generation X employees. Next, according to Togan, 1995, from Bova and Croft, 2001, Generation X think that enhancing their knowledge and skills is a top priority as they think that it will actually enhance their job security. And next, for Bova and Croft, 2001, they agree that Generation X prefer challenging tasks in their workplace and in their daily working life rather than undergoing the same routine every single day. So next, we'll be looking into the Generation Y. They were usually born between 1981 to 2000. According to Hamill 2005 and Haynes 2011, Generation Y look for a more collaborative and participative work style and are keen to achieve a balance between working life and also family life. And according to Murphy 2010, he declared that Generation Y are goal-oriented employees and they are usually motivated by creative leaders. This means that the leaders of the Generation Y employees might need to fulfill the requirement such as critical thinking and also creative thinking. Both of the authors, Hamill and Murphy, did agree that Generation Y are more associated to the modern technology and they are multitasker. It is not surprising because the Generation Y usually grew up within the innovation of technology. So next we'll be looking at a project that is researched according to the expectation of Generation Y, which is named as Oxygen Z. This is a project that carried out by Johnson Controls Global Workplace Solutions that are researched regarding the expectation of Generation Y towards their workplace and their working life. So in this research, according to Holden Holland 2008 and Haynes 2011, the key requirement of Generation Y towards their working environment is listed as below. First of all, they prefer their office to be located in urban area with various facilities. It's because Generation Y thinks that they see office as an extension of their home life. And 79% of Generation Y respondents prefer mobile working, which means that they prefer a more flexible working time and also flexible working hours. Next, Generation Y prefer a working environment that could support their creativity and productivity. So in this case, the organizations that hire Generation Y as their employees could actually provide some activities such as technical support, like a great atmosphere and environment for them, and also interaction with their colleagues. They could actually hold an event that promotes the interaction between the colleagues and between the employees. And next we'll be looking into the expectation of Generation Z. Generation Z are those that are born between 2001 to 2013. There is a survey carried out by Randstad and Future Workplace in 2016 that are regarding by the expectation of Generation Z. 41% of the Generation Z prefer to work in a corporate office. 21% of them prefer to work in a co-working space, while only 20% prefer to work in a home office. It is a surprising result as many of us did believe that Generation Z might prefer the flexible working hours and flexible working place, but in this case, the survey shows that it isn't comes up with what we think. However, in the same survey, 39% of the Generation Z respondents reflect that they prefer face-to-face communication. This is also another surprising result as we always thought that the Generation Z might dislike face-to-face communication, but in this case, in this result, it shows that Generation Z actually prefer this way of communication. While 30% of them actually agree that excellent communication skills is the most crucial skills of a successful leader. Thus, the leader of the Generation Y might need to have a better communication skills to ensure that they could communicate better with their employees and their team players. 90% of them think that work flexibility is the most important staff benefits. And 40% of them think that the training and development is more crucial. According to survey, Generation Z expect their employers to engage technology in their workplace as they embrace and they value the new technologies a lot. The organization of that hires Generation Z could actually provide some flexibility such as robotics, social media, and the virtual reality to engage with their work. So next I'll pass it to Ling.
Next, I'll talk about the reason why employees choose to stay with the organization. And the first one is employee feels that they are engaged in the company. According to Harry S. Myler, employee engagement is defined as a desired outcome that occurs when worker feels an increase in mental and emotional connection to their job, their manager, their colleagues, and the organization mission. Besides that, good communication and exchange of ideas between the manager and employees, such as meetings were carried out between the manager and the employees so that they can communicate well and the employees can understand better their manager expectations in order to be more engaged in their job. When employees are engaged, they are emotionally attached to their organization and willing to put in extra time, energy, and resources in order to achieve the organization goals. According to Gallup study, employees who are engaged in their job are 59% less likely to find another job in the same industry. The next reason is job flexibility. Employees favor to work in a company which allows them to work flexible, such as having a flexible working hours, flexible workloads, and flexible work location. Job flexibility is one of the most important reasons for retaining employees of any age. Flexibility empowers individuals to facilitate a healthier balance between their life and their work. It is important for organizations to provide employment flexibility such as scheduling variations that better accommodate individual work time, individual workload responsibility, and location around family responsibilities. Employees having a flexible job tend to have high level of individual commitment, satisfaction, productivity, loyalty, and mental capacity. And the third one is good compensation and reward offered by the company. Companies that pay their employees based on their achievement is a good way to keep the employees motivated and stay with the job. It is essential for a company to create a compensation structure that supports an employee development program. And some companies are trying to establish a team-oriented working environment and they are rewarding their employees based on individual performance. This kind of practice will help to motivate each individual to work harder to achieve better in performing all the tasks needed and also help to achieve their organization goals. In addition, non-financial rewards such as organizing company trips will also help to retain the employees in the company. Organizing company trip to reward the employees not only helps to motivate the employee to work harder for the company, it also helps us establish good relationship between the employees and establish new work. And next, I will talk about the HR theories or perspective that Fuji Xerox can incorporate. And the first one is Fuji Xerox can set up flexible work arrangement for their employees. Organizations should stop focusing on work-life balance and more on the integration of life and work, which is a model arising in the workplace. Companies should not value the contribution of the employees by just based on the hours, physical hours they work in the office. For instance, time off for appointments and leaving office earlier for personal matter do not mean that employees are not completing their work, but it brings the loyalty and satisfaction in employee. Flexible work arrangement include offering flexible work time and flexible location to work. Flexible work hours include offering flexi time scheme, compressed work week, part-time job, and job sharing. While flexible work locations such as telework or home work allow workers to work remotely from their homes and using telecommunication connection to the workplace if required. And the strengths for this HR perspective is employees' productivity can be improved. Flexibility in jobs allow the employee to operate in an environment that best suits their personal working style, and companies are also able to respond efficiently to the fluctuations in workload. Besides that, flexible work arrangements encourage more senior women to work. Since it provides work flexibility, working mothers and women returning from their maternity leave are also able to work from their home. However, there are also weaknesses for this HR theory. There is no clear delineation between work and home. Flexible working schedule for some employees do not mean that they are working at home during the working hours. They might be sitting at home watching movies with their email screen open. Compressed work week make clients' handover complicated. For instance, clients might expect the employee to work at their office during their business hour in 5 days, and it will be fussy if that worker is not working on a particular day. Next, Fuji Xerox can offer employee share ownership plans to their employees. Direct employee ownership is which employees hold the share and having the option to buy their company shares at a discounted and tax efficiency rate. It provides a strong relationship between the production factors of labor and capital. Employees obtain benefit from their company growth. If the company succeeds and the share value increase, employees will also obtain benefit from their own effort. The strengths for this HR theory is employee share ownership plans help to improve the business productivity. Productivity increase because employees have a vested interest that motivate them to work harder to increase the value of their holdings. Share scheme improves staff retention by providing employees a longer-term focus on the company future's performance. It also helps improve the innovation of the employees. It provides, by providing the employees the ownership, employees will be more engaged in their job that leads to a greater individual innovating and active problem-solving. Weakness is the cost of setting up employee share ownership might be too expensive for some small organizations. Besides that, poor share price performance might occur. When the company share price remains constant or decrease over time, employees will feel that they have no control over the share price, demotivated, and some employees might choose to leave the company. And next, I will pass to Rachel.
Grace. So rather than talking about the strengths and the weaknesses or the HR theories that Fuji Xerox might apply, now we are talking about the Fuji Xerox Malaysia strengths and weaknesses that they carry out along their operations. So now we're looking to the Fuji Xerox Malaysia strength, which is they implement open door policies. Based on the Fuji Xerox Malaysia official websites, one of the top 10 reasons to join Fuji Xerox Malaysia appears to be they implement open door policies in their management. So Fuji Xerox Malaysia actually encourage their employees to seek help and access to their supervisors or managers when they have any difficulties or obstacles in their daily life. And according to PWAS 2013, there are four benefits of open door policies, which are accessibility, open flow of communications, fast access to information, and also close working relationships. So first, we'll look into the first point, which is accessibility. The open door policies actually enables the managers to understand the situation that is happening within the department or the company. It is because it allows the employees to seek help and opinion from the managers whenever they have any obstacles in their work task. Next is open flow of communications. The policy encourages open flow of communication between the managers and also the subordinates, and it allows the both parties to exchange their ideas and also their opinions when the discussion is taking place. Next is fast access to the information. The open door policies allows the managers to have quick access to the information when the employees step forward to seek help from the managers when they have any creative ideas or even difficulties. And it will eventually help the company to keep ahead of the competition. And this is relatively important because the Fuji Xerox Malaysia actually produce the product or services such as printer and also software program, which is included in the IT industry. And in this case, it actually helps the company to keep ahead of any other competitors as the industry is actually fast-paced. So it is actually important to have a quick access to information. And next is close working relationships. So the open door policies actually provides a platform for the employees and also the managers to have better communication as they could exchange their ideas, they could have solve a problem together and have brainstorm together. And this will actually lead to a close working relationship between both parties. And next, we'll look into the Fuji Xerox Malaysia weaknesses, which is lack of training hours for employees. According to Fuji Xerox Malaysia Sustainability Report 2017, it shows that the annual average training hours for per employee is only 2 hours in year 2016. It has decreased dramatically compared to 13 hours in year 2014. And in this case, Fuji Xerox should actually provide sufficient training hours to their employees in order to improve employees' retention. And this could be actually justified by using Maslow hierarchy of needs. And here is an image that is showing the Maslow hierarchy of needs pyramid. We are not going into any of the sector except for safety needs in today's presentation. So providing job security to the employees could eventually satisfy safety needs of the employees in the national hierarchy of needs. It's basic that we know that the job security actually falls into the sector of safety needs. And the employees training and development appears to be a useful and effective solution to increase the employees' job security. So as the employees are joining on taking part in any training and developing program, they are actually increasing their value to the organization and as well as their own personal value. And so, Fuji Xerox Malaysia is advised to increase their employees' training hour and also introduce or implement more training programs to their employees. Next, I'll pass it to Shani.
And now I would like to present about how does these two companies retain their employees well. First is Recall, and the next is Canon. In Recall, their practice adopted by Recall is workplace. First, they are changing of traditional workplace, transform from traditional paper-based to cost-effective digital workflows, more on technological, transform business and empower their workplace, more associated, especially for Gen Y and Z workers. Second is the unique workplace, which are making the environment fully equipped, fully utilized, and fully connected. The third point of the workplace is connect and collaborate. This interconnection between the device is fundamental to activate by empowering digital workplace to anyone, anytime, and anywhere. The second point is the long service and outstanding employees. They have come up with a testimonial booklet. This may make the employee feel motivated and valued. The next is employee engagement program, which is team building. With high engagement, the employees are able to committed well in the organization. Next is the employee recognition. First is award. For example, the Best Employees of the Year, Best Manager Award. Next is the year-end incentive to overseas trip, and also increment of salary and bonus every year. Next is the employee medical benefit, which the company also provides the health insurance for the employees. This is the proof that the recall has done to the employees in order to retain them. The second company is Canon. The practice adopted by Canon, the first point is the modern office environment. The conducive workplace definitely able to attract more Gen Y and Z workers who have more preferred, much conducive workplace. The second point is the medical benefit, which the Canon have provided a comprehensive medical plan for themselves and also the employee's family. The third point is the education support. Canon also provide a scholarship for the employee's children and also car loan interest subsidy. In addition, they also provide a competitive remuneration package. For example, including the salary, wages, but also contains other benefits such as accommodation, telephone, car, etc. This will working out a good remuneration package will help to attract and retain the employee well. And sports, which highly promote healthy lifestyle for the employees. The last one is the parking lot. Canon has provided a convenient parking lot for the employees in order to one of the reasons to retain them. So, as a conclusion, Fuji Xerox should follow what we call a Canon practice. First, they promote a working life, work-life balance, and next, they are able to manage the time well. In addition, they also have good working environment and job security and advancement for these two companies. Employees who have settled in a position in the company are more likely to achieve long-term career goals. With the job advancement is one of the most important elements for the employee satisfaction and retaining them. Here is the reference for our presentation. Okay, thank you. That's all for our presentation.